Everyone, today we discuss about EEG, full form of EEG, that is electroencephalogram. Introduction: it is the study of electrical activity of the brain, and it is the record of electrical activity of cortical neuronal units in a volume conductor. The spontaneous activity which we are recording, that is due to graded or summated postsynaptic potential. This graded summated postsynaptic potential is there in the brain neurons that underlie the recording electrodes at the surface of the skull. It is due to involvement of large number of neurons and their synaptic connections. Now, physiological basis of EEG. Activity recorded in the EEG is that of rhythmically discharging cell bodies in the most superficial layers of cortical gray matter. So, EEG is due to graded potentials which are summated postsynaptic potentials in the brain neurons. This potential changes in the EEG are due to current flow in the fluctuating dipole, and this dipole is formed by dendrites of the cortical cells and their cell bodies. So, dendrites are the sites of non-propagated hypo and hyperpolarizing local potential changes, and cell-dendritic relationship, that is continuously or constantly shifting dipole. Current flow in this dipole produces wave-like potential fluctuations in a volume conductor. And when sum total of this dendritic activity is positive relative to the cell, you can say that cell is hyperpolarized or less excitable. And when the sum total of this dendritic activity is negative as compared to the cell body, the cell is depolarized and also known as hyperexcitable. Now, mechanism of EEG. EEG signals, they are generated by cortex, and currents in the extracellular space generated by summation of EPSPs and IPSPs, and this EPSPs and IPSPs, they get their inputs from certain subcortical structures, and these subcortical structures are thalamus and brainstem reticular formation. Now, invention. EEG was invented by German psychiatrist Hans Berger. Another terminology is electrocorticogram. What is electrocorticogram? That is similar record resembling EEG, but it may be obtained by placing electrodes directly on the pial surface of the cerebral hemisphere, and this is to be performed during neurosurgeries, and it is because it is placed on the cortex, it is known as electrocorticogram. Now, what are the brain waves? When millions of neurons, they fire at a time, this neuron firing, they may produce electrical activity, and this electrical activity is detectable to an electrode placed on the head. Now, electrodes and brain waves. Method of recording EEG, same as ECG, here also two methods are there, two types of electrodes are there, unipolar electrodes and bipolar electrodes. In unipolar electrodes, record of potential difference between active and indifferent electrode, and in bipolar electrode, the potential difference between two active electrodes is recorded. Now, these electrodes are connected to a cathode ray oscilloscope via suitable amplifier, and it has 8 to 16 channels. Now, this recording that is made by International 1020 system. Now, what is this International 1020 system? Electrodes are placed either 10% or 20% of the total distance between a given pair of skull landmark. For example, in a longitudinal line, if we have landmarks or landmark of nasion and inion, so here we are placing the electrodes at 10 20 20 20 20 and 10%. For example, suppose our distance of between nasion and inion is 50 centimeters. When the distance between nasion and inion is 50 centimeters, then first electrode is placed 10% of this 50 centimeters is equal to 5 centimeter distance from nasion, second 10 centimeter, third 10 cm from the second one. So this way we can place the electrode. And in the transverse line, this is again divided by 10 20 20 20 and 10, on the basis of left and right preauricular points. Now, next is electrodes and brain waves. Most electrode caps, they are designed with electrodes over specific areas of the skull, so they are ready made caps are available. And what is the importance of this is, otherwise if we don't place the electrodes according to 1020 system, what we may do is may record the brain waves from different areas of the brain. So always use international 10-20 system. Now, normal EEG. Normal EEG consists of waves, which are oscillations in the electrical potentials of the brain, and they have following characteristics. Number one, different frequency and amplitude. The frequency ranges from 1 cycle per second to maximum 50 cycles per second, and amplitude varies from 20 to 200 microvolts. There are irregular waves and never generalized pattern is obtained. Now, important note is, each EEG tracing is a complex rhythmic wave which never repeats itself precisely. Low EEG frequency denotes less responsive behavior, and high EEG frequency denotes more responsive behavior. Now, important waves of EEG, they are alpha, beta, delta and theta waves. We will discuss one by one, starting with the alpha waves. Alpha waves are rhythmic oscillations in electrical potential. The frequency varies from 8 to 12 Hz and amplitude 50 microvolts. They are recorded from parieto-occipital areas, and they appear when eyes are closed but the person is not sleeping, and they disappear during sleep. So EEG pattern. Now, alpha waves, as we have discussed, they are low amplitude, slow synchronized waves of ideally brain. They are recorded from parietal and occipital region. Here the person is awake and relaxed but eyes are closed. Frequency 8 to 12 cycles per second and amplitude is 50 microvolts. Now, alpha wave frequency decreases in following conditions: in old age with low blood sugar level, low body temperature, low level of adrenal glucocorticoids, increased arterial partial pressure of carbon dioxide. During sleep also frequency decreases, and under the influence of anesthesia and analgesia. And these are the causes for increased frequency. They are high blood sugar level, rise in body temperature, high level of adrenal glucocorticoids, low level of arterial partial pressure of carbon dioxide, and alerting state when person gets alerted. Now, this alpha waves, they are associated with decreased level of attention. And subject reports that he or she is feeling relaxed and happy when alpha rhythm is recorded. Now, another is alpha block, also known as desynchronization of EEG. When eyes are open, this alpha slow synchronized waves, they are replaced by fast irregular low voltage waves, and that is known as alpha block. It is produced by sensory stimulation or mental concentration, also known as arousal or alerting response. Desynchronization means replacement of regular alpha waves by the irregular low voltage waves. Again, you can see here, when eyes are closed, we have slow synchronized alpha waves. But when eyes stay open, this alpha waves are replaced by low voltage rhythm that is known as alpha block. Now, what is the reason for alpha block or desynchronization? When eyes open, activity of brain increases greatly, and synchronization of the signals, they become so little that brain waves nullify one another, and therefore low voltage irregular frequency beta waves, they occur. Now, next is beta rhythm. The frequency of beta rhythm is 14 to 80 Hertz and amplitude is 5 to 10 microvolts. And it is recorded during active or alert state. This is, again, you can see beta waves are there. The strongest from frontal lobe near the precentral gyrus, and they're produced by visual stimuli and mental activation. They're present in other following conditions like tension and CNS activation, arousal response, and barbiturates also induce beta activity with a frequency of 18 to 24 Hertz. Third variety of waves are delta rhythm. They are low frequency, high voltage waves. Frequency 1 to 5 per second, amplitude that is 20 to 200 microvolts. And they are common in children. And in adult, they are present only during sleep. If they are present in adult during wakefulness, they denote tumor, epilepsy, increased intracranial pressure or depression. Next are theta waves. They are not present in normal waking individual. They occur normally in the parietal and temporal region in the children below the age of 5 years. The low frequency, low voltage waves, frequency is 4 to 8 per second and amplitude is about 10 microvolt. They are seen in following condition like emotional stress in the adult, like in disappointment and frustration, also present in the brain disorders like degenerative brain disorders and in children during crying. So these are the frequency and amplitude of different waves, alpha, beta, delta and theta waves. Alpha wave frequency 8 to 13 hertz, amplitude 50 microvolt. Beta wave frequency 14 to 80 hertz and amplitude 5 to 10 microvolts. Delta waves 1 to 5 hertz frequency, 20 to 200 microvolts amplitude, and theta waves frequency 4 to 8 hertz and amplitude is 10 microvolts. Now, neurophysiological basis of EEG. Cortical gray matter along with its thalamic connections play an important role in EEG. Activity recorded in EEG of rhythmically discharging cell bodies in the most superficial layer of the cortical gray matter. And thalamus discharge synchronizes this activity. As we have already discussed that current flow in the fluctuating dipole formed by the cell body and the dendrites of the cortical cell accounts for the potential changes recorded as EEG. Dendrites are the sites of non-propagated hypo and hyperpolarizing local potentials and cell dendritic relationship that is continuously changing dipole. Now, when some of the dendritic activity is positive relative to the cell body, cell are known to be hyperpolarized and less excitable, and the sum total of activity is negative, cells are depolarized and more excitable. And EEG shows graded potentials, which are summated postsynaptic potentials in the brain neurons. Now, synchronizing mechanisms. There are two synchronizing mechanisms active. One is synchronizing activity of neighboring cells, and second is rhythmic discharge from the thalamus. So, first factor, that is synchronizing activity of the neighboring cell. And this is due to the effect of parallel neuronal process on each other in a volume conductor. The interaction of the neurons by inhibitory pathway, and they are hyperexcitable after inhibition. Second factor, that is rhythmic discharge of impulses from thalamus. Stimulation of thalamic nuclei at low frequency rate produces synchronization. And when we are stimulating this with high frequency, produces desynchronization. And lesion in the thalamus results in disturbance in this synchronizing activity of EEG. Now, desynchronizing mechanism. Desynchronization, that is replacement of rhythmic EEG pattern with irregular low voltage activity. And reticular activating system is important system for the response, for it is responsible for desynchronization following sensory stimulation. Now, evidence are stimulation of specific sensory system up to the level of midbrain produces desynchronization. If we are stimulating with high frequency stimulation of reticular formation, then again there is desynchronization. If there is lesion in the brainstem which interrupt medulla and which interrupts the lemnisci and other specific sensory system, that results in failure to prevent desynchronization. Important notes: arousal and EEG desynchronization, they are always coexist, but there are some exceptions. They are, number one is paradoxical sleep. Here there is desynchronization is present, but wakefulness is absent. Second is when we are applying strong nociceptive stimulus, person arouses without desynchronization. Third exception, that is when there is lesion in the posterior hypothalamus, desynchronization is seen without arousal. Variations in the EEG waves with age. In infants, the occipital rhythm is slow than adult, but this occipital rhythm speeds up and reaches to the adolescence level at the age of 15. After 15 years, the pattern becomes like adult. Now, we continue, we discuss about the uses of EEG. It is for localization of pathological condition. Also, it is used for diagnosis of epilepsies, for sleep studies, also for evaluation of comatose patient, evaluation of organic brain disorder, and it is also for evaluation of brain death. Starting with first function, that is localization of pathological condition like subdural hematoma or if fluid is collected over the cortex. This EEG activity we are recording just above that area is reduced. If there is lesion in the cortex also, there is local formation of irregular waves, or you can say slow waves. Second is for diagnosis of epilepsy. Now, what is epilepsy? Here, epilepsy, that is excessive neuronal discharge from cerebral neurons, and because of that, epileptic focus generates high voltage waves. So in epilepsy we have high voltage waves. So here, epilepsy, that is uncontrollable excessive activity of either one part of the brain or from whole the central nervous system. We will be having spike and sharp wave, or sometimes spike and slow waves present in the epileptic individual. And between abnormal waves, we have irregular slow waves appear, and background waveform is also disturbed. Now, types of epilepsies, there are grand mal epilepsy, petit mal epilepsy, and psychomotor epilepsy. In grand mal epilepsy, there is excessive neuronal discharge from all the areas of the brain, and it is characterized by loss of consciousness without any warning sign. A warning sign is aura, and which is followed by generalized convulsions with tonic muscle contraction and clonic jerks, as well as sometimes there is tongue bite. Then here, sometimes from brain to various viscera's signals have been transmitted, so the person may have involuntary defecation, urination. Also, the person may have saliva frothing. The attack lasts for about 3 to 4 minutes, and after attack, after seizure, there is depression of nervous system. So the person is having stupor, loss of consciousness for about 1 minute, and EEG waves, they are either spike or sharp waves present. You can see here, this is the EEG pattern, spike or sharp wave. Second, another thing about that is precipitating factor. Certain factors, they precipitate the attack, and they are strong emotional stimuli, alkalosis, which is caused by overbreathing, voluntary overbreathing. Certain drugs also stimulate grand mal attack. Fever also precipitate the attack, and loud noise or flashing light also precipitate the attack. The attack stops when our neurons, when the neurons of the individual gets fatigued, as well as active inhibition by inhibitory neurons activated by the attack. Second variety of epilepsy, that is petit mal epilepsy. Here there is loss of consciousness. The person is having twitch-like contraction of muscles, mainly usually muscles of the head region, and associated with blinking of eye. Here convulsions are absent. So this is known as absence seizures or absence epilepsy. An EEG pattern, that is spike and dome pattern. Here second strip shows petit mal type of epilepsy, spike and dome pattern is seen. Then other variety is psychomotor epilepsy. Here the person is having inappropriate movements accompanied by hallucination. A short period of amnesia is also present, an attack of abnormal rage. Person is also having sudden anxiety, discomfort or fear, and all these are because of involvement of limbic system. EEG doesn't show any typical change. So this is the second function which we have discussed. Third function, that is evaluation of consciousness dysfunction. In consciousness dysfunction, slow waves, they appear. And these consciousness dysfunctions are of different types. They are coma, stupor, and fainting attack. So coma, that is loss of consciousness from which arousal cannot be possible. Here, a lesion blocking connection between the ascending reticular activating system and thalamus, and also associated with reduction in the oxygen consumption of the brain. And when it is stimulated by sensory pathway, sometimes desynchronization is observed in EEG. Other consciousness dysfunction, that is syncope or fainting, that is transient pathological loss of consciousness, and stupor, that is third variety, which is more persistent loss of consciousness, but from which arousal can be obtained. Fourth function of EEG, that is evaluation of organic brain dysfunction. Functional trouble occurs due to cerebral tumor or brain blood vessel trouble, like infarction to particular area, or emboli or brain injury. Here there is abnormal wave formation and slow waves are present, and these slow waves are according to seriousness of brain functional trouble. More serious is the trouble, a large amount of slow waves are present in the EEG. And fifth function, last but not least, that is evaluation of brain death. EEG, that is the criteria for labeling brain death. If we have a straight line in the EEG for 30 minutes, we can claim the person as brain death. And why do we require to claim the person as a brain death? Because for the organ transplantation, we have to confirm brain death, as well as to remove the support, we have to confirm the brain death. So this is all about the EEG. Thank you all.